So welcome back to another training vlog, another week. Today is like a two-a-day, so there'll actually be some proper training today. As a change from last week, it's about 10 o'clock in the morning now. It's Saturday. I'm going to do a running session. Hopefully there'll be some video of this running session. Just where I'm running, it's pretty flat and pretty straight. So I'm just going to set up the camera at the start, like maybe on the dash of the Jeep. And you should be able to see some of it. The runs are going to be some 800s. We're not going to have the best running shoes. I'm going to see, can I find them? These are the kicks for today. Tight up tight skate shoes. Who needs fancy runners? Basically, I don't have my running shoes with me. I'm going to try and like show what I'm eating, or show some of what I'm eating, or most of it anyway, at least before and in between the two sessions and after the squat session. We've a live stream with the Sika members at 12, so I better get going pretty soon. I hope you enjoy it. So first thing is just like some monster with some whatever this is, like creatine, glutamate and taurine, just before the running session. Usually like half a can of Monster. I'll fill the rest up with water. You can't actually see that. Fill the rest up with water. And you're good to go. This Monster, by the way, is the fucking best Monster. Ultra Fiesta. So for the people last week who were asking how I'm measuring distance, obviously you saw last week's run was measured with like Google Maps, just using the measure distance function. But this week was using both that on Google Maps and just using a laser rangefinder to kind of double check or make sure. It's always pretty close anyway. Anytime I've kind of checked them one against the other, they're very, very similar. That rangefinder is accurate to within, I think, half a meter at 1,000 meters, so that should be plenty accurate enough for me. This is just some quick clips of the running session. These runs were difficult. Like, you'll see at the end how wet the ground is and how kind of soft the sand is. So even though it's nice and flat and it's a straight run, like just one straight line, which is obviously very advantageous, the disadvantage is the actual surface itself. Like, some places it's nice and hard and flat, other places it is kind of very, very up and down, very soft, running through some puddles. So you'll actually get to see at the end, when I drive along the track, you'll get to see just how kind of rough it is. Here's just some of me dying. So this is just a few 800 meter runs. Not terribly fast, but not very slow either. And yeah, that's it. Enjoy. What you're seeing here is picking up the 400 meter mark. So I just leave something halfway along the way. You would have seen at the very start that it was just a squat stand, like a H stand. They used to mark either end, one on both sides, and then this is just like a tackle box I leave in the middle. I like to have a like 50-50 split with the 400 meter mark. It's just making sure I'm not going out too fast out of the gate, or likewise not going too slow out of the gate. You'll kind of see the ruts in the ground here. So the sand is quite soft. I was expecting it to be a bit harder. But yeah, no harm. So live stream done. It's 10 to 2 now. And it's time for like the first like proper meal. And
I'll be going on to squats afterwards. So it's literally just like venison curry leftovers from last night's dinner. Have some water with that. Then before training, so before squats, I'll just be having the other half of a can of Monster. I'll probably have a cup of coffee like somewhere in between. And I'm going to wait an hour or two anyway to train. Next bit of food is, it's 20 past three and it's like coffee, biscuits, shitload of milk. That's it.
Today's squat session is tens. So you would have seen last week was maxing out front squat, maxing out back squat. I'm about 6 weeks out or 4 weeks out, sorry, from testing. So testing a back squat and testing the 1 mile for hopefully a 500 pound squat and a 5 minute mile. So I've gone back to do some tens. I'm not really a fan of getting away from volume for too long. Definitely in the kind of shape I'm in now, it's no harm to keep volume in there a bit longer. So yeah, usual warm-up tens with an empty bar. I didn't do any proper general warm-up for this session. To say there was no enthusiasm for lifting weights today would be a gross understatement. So yeah, some tens with an empty bar, some reps with 70, some reps with 110, and then three sets of 10 with 130. Then just some bodybuilding afterwards.
Touch my mouth and hold my tongue. I'll never be your chosen.
These days of dark, wish we'd known, will blow away with this new
sun. So, first working set. No belt, no knee sleeves for this. These, like, the relative weights here are just very, very light, so it's basically just getting started again. If you want to see a video of basically this kind of shed being turned into a place where training is possible, there's going to be a vlog. Like, it took a few days just to get shelving up and get everything organized, so there's going to be a vlog going up tomorrow morning, or it might actually be up already depending on when you're watching this. And hopefully you enjoy it. Let us know anyway.
Thank you.
So thanks very much for watching another training vlog. If you could comment below purely for the algorithm, or comment with questions or comments or the usual shit talk, that would be great. Also, if you could like the video and subscribe, we'd really appreciate it. And yeah, that's it. We'll see you all again next week.